हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजे इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज़ एपिसोड 149। एवर सिंस द अराइवल ऑफ बैटलग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया फॉर एंड्रॉइड डिवाइसेस, फैंस एंड प्लेयर्स हैव बीन डिस्परेटली वेटिंग फॉर सम ई-स्पोर्ट्स एक्शन। विद क्राफ्टम प्रॉमिसिंग इंडियन स्पेसिफिक लीग्स एंड टूर्नामेंट्स, द एक्साइटमेंट्स अमंग फैंस इज एट द पीक्स। एंड द क्राफ्टम अनाउंस्ड दैट द फर्स्ट बैटलग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया टूर्नामेंट कॉल्ड द बैटलग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया सीरीज 2021 एन ओपन इवेंट फॉर ऑल द मैसिव प्राइस पूल ऑफ 1 crore इंडियन रुपीज। एज पर द न्यू ट्वीट ऑन बैटलग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया ऑफिशियल अकाउंट, द न्यू एंड डेट अकॉर्डिंग टू द BGMI विल बी अनाउंस्ड सून। Apple has introduced 3 new payment modes for the App Store in India. This will allow users to choose from additional payment options if they want to make a purchase. The new payment modes on the Apple App Store include Unified Payments Interface, RuPay cards, and the net banking. Before this, Apple App Store and iTunes only accepted credit cards or Visa and MasterCard debit cards. This will come in the handy of Indian users as it allows them to make purchase or in-app purchases without having to use their credit or debit card. Apple sent out notifications to users that they can now make payments using UPI, RuPay and net banking. Although several smartphone makers have already launched many true wireless products in India, the new brands are still coming into the same segment. Similarly, Deezo, which is a Realme partner brand, has recently launched a true wireless and a wireless earphone. And however, you will be surprised to know the company has huge plans for the Indian market. And he mentioned that till now, Deezo has launched 4 products in the market and plans to add more products by end of this year. They are planning to launch more than 16 products in the smart home accessories, smart care and smart entertainment segment, as the CEO said. And he also mentioned that the company wants to become a number one true wireless brand in the next 2 years. Social media giant Facebook chief executive Mark Zuckerberg has informed investors that the company is working to mold itself into a metaverse company. The idea, which Zuckerberg revealed in the company town hall recently and then during an interview with The Verge, is to build virtual environments akin to those seen in the science fiction movies like Ready Player One. And it will allow users to interact in a virtual place that is driven by companies like Facebook and other tech giants like it. If you are looking for more science fiction examples, think about the Quest word from the animated series is Johnny Quest. Days after Apple presents its new MagSafe power packs, and other cell makers are emulating Apple's example. As of date, Realme teases a stick-on remote charger that will also call as Realme MagDart, which is set to be declared on August 3, 2021. Today, we have figured out how to uncover renders of another Oppo remote charger that can be authoritatively reported soon. And this comes days after we have recently announced Oppo equipment to dispatch its form of MagSafe. Back in Feb, Realme was touted to launch the gaming accessories in the Indian market alongside the Nexus 30 smartphone series at the launch event. Eventually, the phone made it to the market, but the accessories, including a gaming mouse and a mouse pad, were never materialized. Now, after almost few months after, a new mouse from Realme has been certified online. A mouse carrying model number RMW2024 has appeared on a new certification revealing its existence. This is expected to be the much-rumored Realme mouse. It has a 1.5 watt battery and it is expected to be fully wireless. Telecom operators in India are no longer bundling SMS benefits with a low-value prepaid recharge plans that are available under Rs. 100. As an industry-wide practice, players including Reliance Jio, Airtel and Vodafone Idea have updated their entry-level plans to not club them with any SMS package allocation. It will be a major blow to low-paying customers for whom outgoing SMSs mean TC to facilities like mobile number portability as well as SMS-based access to service including Unified Payments Interface. Telegram added video calls with up to 1,000 viewers, video messages 2.0, video playback speed and many more. This update takes video to a higher level, gathering video calls currently have up to 1,000 watchers. Video messages record is more excellent than can be extended. Ordinary recordings might be watched at 0.5 or 2 times speed. We have likewise adding screen imparting to sound to all the video calls, remembering one for one calls are considerably more. Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 and Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 are required to be the solitary two models in the smartphone series this year. Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 series will highlight a Percy UI with a blend of components from Tizen OS and Google Wear OS. The wearables are replied upon the disclosed on August 11th. Google is finishing sign-in help for extremely old adoption of Android. This is being done to ensure clients' record protection. Clients with dynamic Android 2.3.7 or more seasoned gadgets will not have an option to sign in our record on Gmail, YouTube, and other Google applications. Huawei Thursday launches its flagship P50 Pro alongside the P50 and some other high-end products. The Huawei P50 Pro features some excellent functions, including a powerful camera setup. The P50 Pro's camera has been put through the paces of DxOMark, a camera review and a test platform. The review reflects the impressive performance of the camera setup, the Huawei P50 Pro. The overall DxOMark score showed the P50 Pro is the current leader in smartphone cameras with a score of 144. The 13-megapixel front-facing camera had a combined score of 106, which is also at the top of this category. The selfie camera's picture quality was very good, with low noise and substantial detail preservation and effective video stabilization. And the 50-megapixel primary sensor as well as a 40-megapixel monochrome module of the P50 Pro are also capable of a great picture and a video quality. The Huawei P50 Pro also has a 64-megapixel periscope camera for zoomed shots, which is obviously a leader in the category with low noise, detail preservation and a wide dynamic range. Bulgaria is one of the few countries left in Europe that doesn't have its own Mi store. But that's not the case anymore. The company officially unveiled its first Mi store in the country's capital, Sofia. According to the leakster Abhishek Yadav, the source Xiaomi discontinued Mi 11 Lite 4G in India. Now they will be launching Mi 11 Lite 5G in India. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.